Hi. In today's session, I will explain how you can automatically scale OpenSearch with AWS. My name is Hajar Bouafif. I am a specialist solutions architect at AWS, and I am focusing on analytics services. Today, I will walk you through the following points. First of all, I will introduce what is OpenSearch. Then I will introduce OpenSearch serverless and present you the flexibility in choice to choose between OpenSearch serverless and Amazon OpenSearch provisioned offering for search and analytics use cases. And finally, I will share few takeaways and next steps to use OpenSearch serverless. OpenSearch is a community-driven open source search and analytics suite derived from Apache 2.0 licensed Elasticsearch 7.10.2 and Kibana 7.10.2. OpenSearch Engine is a distributed search engine that is powered by Apache Lucene, and it provides a data visualization tool to build dashboards and visualizations called OpenSearch Dashboards. OpenSearch provides tools and plugins to provide additional functionalities such as anomaly detection, alerting, observability, etc. OpenSearch is used in two main use cases. The first one is for log analytics, where you want to perform log monitoring, microservice observability, security analytics to help investigate security incidents. Or the second main use case is for search, where you want to empower your internal application or internet-facing applications like an e-commerce website to help your end users find the relevant product and fine-tune the product recommendations. OpenSearch is supported by AWS, and all components are available under the Apache license version 2.0 on GitHub. And the project roadmap is publicly available, and it welcomes community contributions. Currently, customers can use Amazon OpenSearch Service, which is a fully managed service that helps customers to run the open source OpenSearch software at scale. Customers need to create a dedicated domain per type of workload, search or log analytics, configure that workload, and make it performant for each use case. When you create a domain in Amazon OpenSearch Service, you select a specific type of nodes, data and leader nodes, from the wide range of Amazon EC2 instances to match your workload compute requirements in terms of ingestion and search. Customers also need to size each domain based on the storage requirements, and you can leverage also different storage tier, hot, warm, or cold, if possible, to reduce cost and manage the index lifecycle. But what are the challenges with the provisioned option? First, you need to pre-deploy for peak usage. You need to make sure that you have sufficient capacity to meet the cost and availability goals. Second, it requires expertise to use Amazon OpenSearch Service in terms of understanding how the sharding mechanism works, the indexing lifecycle, to make sure that the domain is performant and optimized for your workload. Third, you need to continuously monitor to update the sizing and configurations as the workload demand change in time. Some organizations do not want to manage their OpenSearch domains to build the correct sizing, fine-tune the indices, and performance of the domain. Others don't have the dedicated resources or expertise to operate large clusters on their unpredictable workloads. These customers want to focus on their business using OpenSearch without having to think about performance tuning or domain capacity. This is why we recently introduced Amazon OpenSearch Serverless, which is a new serverless option for Amazon OpenSearch Service that automatically provisions and scales the underlying resources to deliver fast data ingestion and query response for the most demanding and unpredictable workloads. Serverless removes the operational complexities for provisioning, configuring, and tuning your OpenSearch clusters. And with OpenSearch Serverless, you can easily and fast start with the service to search and analyze petabytes of data without having to worry about the underlying infrastructure and data management. OpenSearch Serverless integrates with the different services within AWS ecosystem, such as Amazon's Kinesis data firehose to ingest the data. And also the APIs are accessible from AWS SDK, CLI, or the console. With serverless, you only pay for what you use in terms of compute and storage. OpenSearch Serverless is now generally available across 8 AWS regions globally. Currently, serverless collections run OpenSearch version 2.0.x. As new versions are released, OpenSearch Serverless will automatically upgrade your collections to consume new features. Let's go into more details about the new serverless option and how you can start using it. In serverless, you will create collections. Each collection represents a set of indices that has the same purpose in terms of use case. As you can see in the screenshot, you must select what is the primary use case for your collections, time series or search. Time series focuses on analyzing large volumes of semi-structured time series data for your operational and user behavior insights, for example. The search use case focuses on the full-text search capabilities. On the other hand, the compute in serverless is powered by OpenSearch Compute Units, OCUs, instead of EC2 instances like in the provisioned OpenSearch option. Each OCU has 6 gigabytes of RAM with one vCPU and includes 120 gigabytes of index data. A total of 4 OCUs are instantiated when you create the first collection in an account. 2 for ingest, including primary and standby, and 2 for search, includes one replica for high availability. All subsequent collections with same AWS KMS key share these OCUs. On the other hand, collections with unique AWS KMS key cannot share those OCUs with other collections. So now let me dive more into the technical innovation behind OpenSearch Serverless. Traditional OpenSearch clusters have a single set of instances that perform both indexing and search operations. And of course, index storage is tightly coupled with compute capacity. In contrast, OpenSearch Serverless uses a cloud-native architecture that separates the indexing component from the search component, with Amazon S3 as the primary data storage for indices. This decoupled architecture lets you scale search and indexing functions independently of each other and independently of the indexed data in S3, which contrasts with the provisioned offering. The first entry point to OpenSearch Serverless is through the service gateway. The gateway will route the request to search or ingestion compute. On the indexing side, you have an active-passive model where you have a primary active OCU and another standby resource in another availability zone for high availability. On the search side, OpenSearch Serverless functions with 2 search replicas running in active-active mode. In search type collections, most data is stored into the hot cache or the OCUs to ensure fast query response times up to 6 terabytes. For time series collection, we keep the most recent data in the hot cache or the OCU to optimize query response times for more frequently accessed data. You can configure the maximum indexing and search capacity on the account and region level up to 50 OCUs for each compute requirement, search or indexing. And you can monitor the search OCU and indexing OCU on the account level using CloudWatch metrics to understand how your collections are scaling. So now let's take an example of indexing request. When you write data to a collection, OpenSearch Serverless distributes it to the indexing compute units. All requests to indexing originate on the service gateway. The service gateway translates the collection endpoint for customers into the respective indexing endpoint. The coordinator sends the documents within the request to the respective index worker or OCU based on the shard routing, and each OCU will hold a subset of shards, and then each segment Lucene is in turn pushed to Amazon S3. When you perform a search on the collection data, gateway checks permission and OpenSearch serverless, here the coordinator, will route the request to the search compute units that hold the data being queried and sends back the response. As mentioned, all the data is stored in S3, but in search traffic, the indices will be hydrated from S3 to the search compute unit that will download the indexing data directly from S3 if it is not already cached locally. It will run the search operation, perform aggregations, and return the response. As shared earlier, Amazon OpenSearch Serverless will scale up and down based on your requirements. When there is a sudden peak on the ingestion side, for example, the service will automatically trigger to scale up to provide more ingestion compute units when needed. As you can see, more OCUs will be added based on the threshold breaches that will trigger the auto-scaling. No configuration or explicit action required from your end-user perspective. The service will automatically analyze the utilization metrics on the ingestion level at regular intervals to trigger the auto-scaling. Same on the search compute side. The service will automatically scale up and down based on the workload compute requirements. Bear in mind that the auto-scaling on the search compute triggers independently from the ingestion compute. So here, the search workload will not interfere with the indexing workload. Moving to the security aspect of serverless. With serverless, you need to set up policies and assign collection to your policies to make it functional. You have encryption policy that will define the which key to use per collection. Bear in mind that the data in serverless is encrypted by default at rest and in flight. Then the second type of policy is network policy, where you define a list of rules to define the access type, whether public access or inside the VPC, and the resource type, whether you want the collection endpoint within the VPC or publicly available, and also separately the OpenSearch dashboards endpoint. The third type of policy is data access policy, where you will define the principles, permission, and the index collection level resources, and define the user's access to the data inside the collection. You can also use SAML 2.0 authentication for dashboards like Okta, Keyload, etc. In order to manage collection at scale, we recommend to configure the encryption, network, and data access policies first before creating collections. You can continue using the same open source tools that you currently use to publish logs to OpenSearch serverless collections. Moving to pricing. So, in OpenSearch serverless, you're charged for the following component: data ingestion compute, search and query compute, and the storage retained in Amazon S3. Given the nature of serverless, the billing will follow the compute resources used in time. So you see the variation in the green line in time within the graph. You can configure a maximum number of OCUs for your account. On the other hand, with OpenSearch provisioned offer, you will always pay for the resources dedicated for each domain, whether you use those resources or not, as you can see in the blue line. Now, to start with, Amazon OpenSearch serverless is very fast and easy, as I'm explaining. The first collection will take probably up to 5 minutes, and subsequent ones less than 1 minute. It takes up to a minute or less to set up policies, rules, such as security policy. You can use your existing client, as I mentioned, and you can update the configuration files to point to OpenSearch serverless endpoints and add the SIGV4 header to each request. And you're done. So what's next? With OpenSearch serverless offering, you now have the option or the choice to choose between OpenSearch managed offering and serverless. If you have expertise in OpenSearch internals and you want to control your domain configurations, go with Amazon OpenSearch provisioned offering. And if you want to only focus on your business insight, go with Amazon OpenSearch serverless, which will manage all the operational tasks on your behalf. The main takeaways that I want to leave you with today are, first of all, you can continue using your familiar open source ingestion and pipelines without having to change your applications, which allow you to easily start with open source serverless. You can focus on your business insights since the service automatically provision and continuously adjust to get fast data ingestion rates and response time. Last but not least, with OpenSearch serverless, you no longer need to over-provision for peaks and you pay only for what you use. Finally, I leave you a few links to start with OpenSearch serverless, public documentation, available blog post, and the workshop on getting started with Amazon OpenSearch serverless. Thank you, everyone.